हाय एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ शुभांगी सारुंके, एचओडी ऑफ बीशर सिविल डिपार्टमेंट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट बिल्डिंग प्लानिंग एंड ड्राइंग 2 to 405 एंड द चैप्टर नंबर इज 4, दैट इज ड्राइंग ऑफ फ्रेम स्ट्रक्चर। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द ड्राइंग ऑफ टू स्टोरेज फ्रेम स्ट्रक्चर। देन वी हैव सीन अबाउट डेटा ड्राइंग। इन डेटा ड्राइंग वी हैव सीन डेवलपमेंट प्लान, elevation, section, site plan, and now we are going to see the foundation plan, schedule of opening, construction notes and etc. So let's start it. Now the location plan. In the location plan, a two distance and one angular measurements, or a distance of site from the permanent object at two corner of the plots are used. In the location plan, the boundary towards all the direction, that is north, south, west, east, are described. Their boundaries are fixed with respect to some permanent object around the plot. For example, like this. In the location plan, what we have to show? You have to show your plot with respect to some or the other permanent structure. Like if there is a temple, then you have to show the temple with respect to that temple. Where is your plot? We have to show it. Like this, if you want to show our college location, or a plot location of our college, then obviously we have to show the Hanuman temple. And in the side of Hanuman temple, you can see there is a school, and after, in front of school, the Rohini Patri Polytechnic College is there. So like this, we have to draw the location plan. The location plan has been drawn in the scale of 1:5000, 1:600. Okay, the next one is a foundation plan. Foundation plan show the excavation that must be done on the site for laying down the foundation of the building. Load bearing and frame structure differ in their foundation. Both the foundation plans differ from each other. The diagonal measurements are checked for the accuracy of the foundation plan. This is a foundation plan of a frame structure. This is different than the foundation plan of load bearing structure. What is different in this? In this, we have to show compulsory only the footing. You can see, okay, they have also given the number to a footing like C1, C2, C3, C3, C4, C5, C6, like this. Okay, after giving the number to a footing, you have to show the columns. After showing the columns, you have to also show the footing, the dimension of the footing, and after showing the dimension of the footing, wherever the column is present, in that you have to show the footing. Okay, see, if the black one is a column, then you can see around it there is a dot dot dash 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 line, and that is the footing. Okay, the footing dimension can be of 0.9 to 1.2 meter. Okay, and as you can see, the distance, the center to center footing dimension has been mentioned over here. Okay, and also after drawing center to center dimension, then you have to draw the diagonal line. Why the diagonal line? Because you have to check the the perpendicular and the horizontal line from that diagonal line only. So this is how the foundation plan is to be made. Okay, wherever the columns is present, you have to place the column over there, and then you have to draw the footing around that column, and after drawing the footing, we have to give the center to center distance between each and every footings, and after giving center to center distance from each and every footing, then we have to draw the diagonal line to check the accuracy of that line. So like this, the foundation plan of the frame structure has been drawn. Then the schedule of opening. Obviously, the schedule of opening is very important. Why? Because we have to mention here the size of the door and windows. We have to describe ki this door is made up of which material and where that door has been placed. For example, door, that is, the symbol is G, the number is 1. We have only used one door of this dimension, 1000 into 2000, and what is description? That is of timber wood framework with a single shutter door, and where we are using it on an external wall, that is on an external door. Like this, we have to mention each and every door, whatever door we are using. If we are using D1, D2,
For D1 the dimension is different, for D2 the dimension is different. And where we are using it for external door or in a WCN bath, we have to mention that also. In a remark we have to mention that. Then come to a window. Why window? Because it is also come under a opening. So in a window we have W1, W2, okay, we also have a ventilators, okay. So W dimension is 1500 into 1300. Window, that is window W we are using for three type. Means three windows are present in a plan of this size. Okay, it have a galvanized window of fully glass and we are using it in a living room. Like this, if you are using W1, W2, we have to mention the number of W1 you are using, W2 you are using, also the dimension, the description that the window is made up of, and where you are using, in living room, in WC, in bath, in kitchen, or where. So I have to mention that also. By seeing the schedule of opening, you get to know ki where this window has been used, at which unit, either in living room, bathroom, or where, and what is the number of that. Like this, you can obviously you have to write the schedule of opening. It can come for a 5 marks also. Then the next part is a construction note. The example of general construction notes are given below. Like this, whatever we can't mention in the drawing, we have to write it in a construction note. For example, the concrete bed for a foundation masonry is PCC. At the very starting, we have to place in PCC. Okay, the foundation bed has an PCC, and what the material we are using, 1:4:8 in a proportion of 1:4:8, and what is the thickness is 20 centimeter thick. Obviously this thing we can't draw or we can't mention in the drawing, therefore we have to write in a construction note. Start from the ground and then go till the parapet wall. Then we will come for a hard foundation available at 0.90 mm below the ground level. Then we have a foundation and the plinth masonry in UCR, in CM, cement mortar of 1:5. Then we have a plinth height of 60 cm above the ground level. Then we have a superstructure of BB masonry. Then we have a roof. In a roof we are using a Bangalore tiles, that is red color tiles, etc. So we have to mention the projection of the roof is 45 centimeter. Like this, we have to mention each and everything which we can't mention in our drawing. Like flooring, for a flooring we are using a mosaic tiles. Then in WC and bath we are using a dados. The height of a dados is 1 meter. Like this, we have to mention each and everything in a construction note. Even the plinth projection is 7.5 centimeters also throughout the all the sides of the building. So this also I have to mention in a construction note. The next one is a schedule of area. Means in this we get to know ki what is the area of a plot, what is the area of area we are getting for a build up, then what is the area of plinth area, carpet area, and etc. Like this, the plot area means now whatever the area we are getting from the plot, we have to multiply it, and then whatever area we are getting, we have to simply write it. Permissible area means 1/3 of the plot area. Build up area means actually how much area you have been constructed or you have been using. And then plinth area is same as the plot area, build up area. And then the carpet area is only of an the area which we are using it excluding the wall thickness. The area which have been left excluding the wall thickness, that is our usable area, that is our carpet area. Like this, we have to mention the areas and how you calculated that area, you have to write in a remark. So like this, you have to write the schedule of area also. The next one is the detail of RCC components. In a RCC component, the first one is the isolated footing. In a footing, okay. This is a plan and this is a section. This one is a plan and this one is a section. In a plan, as you can see, the center one is a column. Obviously, the center one is going as in column. You can see over here, it is going above. Therefore, it is a column. And around it, there is a footing. So, they have also mentioned the footing dimension. That is 1200 into 1200 is a footing dimension. Okay, like this you can see the column dimension is 450 into 450 and internal whatever the this is going, what the bars and everything is going is of dimension of 230 mm, like this. Okay, and inner section as you can see it is considered as in height. So first it is a PCC. So PCC is 150 mm thick, then there is a 200 mm of RCC footing, then the inclined part is of 200 mm, that is also including footing, and then the column is going above. Like this you have to draw the isolated footing section and plan both. Okay, the next one is lintel and chhajja. Usually in exam the lintel and chhajja detailing is been asked. It's very simple. What is lintel and what is chhajja? The first diagram is about the chhajja with the lintel. Okay, that this part is known as the lintel and the projection part is known as in chhajja. The chhajja here is projected as 600 mm. Okay, here they have also been written there the size of the bars. Okay, the internal bar is of 6 mm dia and the distance between the bars is 200 mm. Then there is a external bars of 8 mm dia and the distance between that bar is 150 mm, like this. In a bottom, okay, the beam, whatever the beam they are using, the top bars have 2 bars of 9 mm, bottom bar have 3 bars of 12 mm, then the ring, okay, this is known as a ring which is around the bars. So ring is of 6 mm dia at 200 mm. Like this you have to draw the cross section of chhajja. Okay, the opening part which has been there is 80 mm and the lintel is 200 mm. So this is all about your lintel. Okay, the projection or the end of the lintel is 50 mm. Then we come to a lintel. This is a lintel, you can see this is a lintel, and lintel have a stirrups and the main bar, the stirrups and main bar, and with that they have also mentioned the lintel has been about the door and windows. So the distance of the lintel is 1.2 meter like this, and the description of the bar has been mentioned over here. So this is a cross section of lintel and chhajja which we have to draw it. Then we have a cross section of the staircase. This is a cross section of staircase. First we have to draw the plan of the staircase. Like this you have to draw the plan of the staircase. Throughout the staircase there is a brick masonry work, and inside there is a two landing. After landing there is a flight. One flight is going up and second flight is going down. Like this there are two flights. Okay, after drawing this you can see this is a plan, sorry, this is a section which you have seen now. This section, one section is going about, the second section is also going about. In one section they have given the main reinforcement, okay, the detail of reinforcement. Okay, wherever the first step is coming you can see this is the elevation part of the first step, from where they are flight has been starting. So from here the flight has been starting, that is elevated, and from there, okay, they have been going about, and then there is a landing. After placing a landing then they have given the steps and everything, and then they have placed over here a landing. Okay, you can see there is a stirrup bar also present over here. Okay, how the stirrup bar has been placed over here they have mentioned over here. Okay, the steel bars of 8 mm dia at the rate 90 mm distance. You can see this round bars which has been, we can see from here this round type of bar is 8 mm dia. The this one which is an horizontal part is a main steel of 10 mm. Okay, this is of main steel of 10 mm. Okay, then you can see over here. Okay, the diameter of this is 215 mm. Okay, LD means what? The distance from landing to a first step is 470 mm. Okay, like this you can also see over here they have given the rising. Okay, the riser is 150 mm, the threaded 270 mm, the reinforcement bar is also been present. okay, LD is also been given over here. Then there is a floor level, the lap length is also been given, lap length is 470 mm. Okay, here is a wall, this one is a wall which has been going up for, okay. So like this, this is a staircase which we have to draw the detail of the staircase with the reinforcement. In reinforcement you have to mention the details also of reinforcement. Then this is a frame structure. In a frame structure, as you can see, there is a ground floor also and there is a first floor also. In a ground floor, if the section line is cutting from here, even in the first floor, the section line should be cutting from here only. They have also place a furniture. It is optional. If you want to place a furniture, then only you can place it. As you can see, the entrance is over here. They have also given the chacha projection. Door, windows has been present over here. Okay. Then in a first floor there is a terrace. As you can see over here, the open terrace has been mentioned, therefore you have to denote the open terrace like this. Okay, then here is a WC and bath. Above this there is also a WC and bath. See, here is a column. Even in a ground floor here is a column, means you have, you don't have to change the column place. Okay, first if you show the column over here, then in the first floor also the column should be here only. Like this, if the column is here, then in a ground floor also the column should be here only. Like this, the column should be at same place only, even if you are constructing at first floor, ground floor or anywhere. Okay, then the next plan, this is a ground floor and first floor. Then this is a elevation. Okay, this is an elevation of our building. You can see from a front side there is a first of veranda, and after here is a hall. So from here you have to go inside, here is a hall. After here is an open terrace. So they have mentioned over here, this is a railing. Okay, here is open terrace, here is a room, and it is a staircase going about, and here is a terrace. So, and this distance is plinth height. Plinth height 0.6 has been mentioned over here, and here is a staircase, and it is also a railing over present over here. Like this, the elevation you have to draw it. And this is a section part. Obviously, the section, how the section line is going, you have to draw your section like that only. Here the footing, you can see the footing is different than the our load bearing structure. Okay, there is also a staircase. Okay, and then as you can see in the section line how it is cutting, if here is a door, they have mentioned the door also, the section line is cutting the bathroom, they have mentioned the bathroom with the dados, they have placed over dados. Here is a chacha, they have also mentioned the chacha. Okay, and then floor to floor height has also been mentioned over here. Here is open terrace, so they have given the open terrace over here. Like this you have to draw the section. This is a foundation plan. Okay, this is how the foundation plan has been there. You have to place only the columns. After a column, you can see there is an footing has been drawn around the columns. Okay, this is a plinth beams, which has been plinth beam is same as a wall thickness. Okay, so you have to draw the plinth beam. After drawing the plinth beam, you have to draw the center line from the center of the plinth beams, and after that you have to give a diagonal line from this column to this column to check the accuracy of the this length, and then the center distance is to be mentioned in here. Okay, so this is a foundation plan. This is a site plan and the location plan. Simply you can draw the location plan like this. Here is a streets, here is a plot, this is your plot, so you have to hatch it. Okay, this is your plot. After drawing this, here is a playground, and also there is a north direction present over here. This is a location plan and this is a site plan. In site plan you have to mention the plot, okay, build up area or a plot, and you have to hatch it. Wherever the kitchen and bathroom is present, here they have to write the NTNT, and outside you have to write GTGT. Then you have to go to the inspection chambers, also should be present over here. You have to show the road of 6 meter width or anything. then the water supply line has been connecting to in kitchen, so we have to show that also. And then the plot has been built, whatever may be your build up area, then 3 meter from here, 3 meter from here, 3 meter from here, and 4 meter from here. And then you have to draw the rectangle, and the area of the rectangle is the area of a plot area. So like this you have to draw the side plan. So this is all about your frame structure. Nothing else can be come in the frame structure. In the live lecture I will show you how to draw the frame structure. Till now, thank you everyone.